All right. So I'll say it again. Thank you, Tom. Thank you, George. Thank you, Chamber. What a difference a year makes. As you can see, no Solon Bowl today. No big lunches. No signature. I just took a quick glance at my New York Times front page today, and we're living in some really challenging times, and I don't have to tell you that. Our president and vice president lamented and mourned the 500,000 Americans that have passed away over this last year through the pandemic. There's ongoing political strife and a ransacking of our Capitol just a few weeks ago. I saw an article about the depression and suicide rates in Japan and what's happening in Texas, how horrible what's happening to especially the folks without electricity and without water. And as you guys know me, I have three pillars in my life: my family, my faith, and my community. And today I want to talk about my community. Solon did an amazing job through the pandemic. We did it because we were resilient. We did it together. We did it because of our families, our love. We did it through health. We did it through wellness. We did it, yes, I say it a lot, but I probably never meant it more since I've been mayor. We did it because of Team Solon. And now I'm going to tell you a little bit about our team and how we got through the pandemic through strength and through resiliency. First off, I want to talk a little bit about City Council. There's a lot that goes on, a lot of strife in Washington, Columbus. We have something very novel here. We have an administration, a mayor and council that actually get along, that actually work together. Frankly, that actually are good friends. Some of my dearest friends are on City Council, and a mayor and council that sometimes love each other, even though we have some disagreements. It's the best council I think I've ever seen in this community, and they've done so much through the pandemic, allowed me to get through it, get through some very difficult times and challenging times, but also the road ahead is bright, and I'm optimistic because of the group that I work with. Mackie Bentley, Ward 1, the chair of our Planning Commission, brings a smile to everyone's face. Bob Palunas, Ward 2. Bobby and I have worked together, I think, for 20 years on City Council, and I consider him a dear friend. Jeremy Zellwin, my buddy, Ward 3, who chaired the Finance Committee and just did a yeoman's job to making sure that we were on budget, on time, making sure we cut when we needed to cut, and making sure that our finances were in place. Mark Katora, my brother in Ward 4. If you're ever downtown, you got to get to Galushi's and get some great food. Ward 6, what a great ward. My buddy, Bob Schimmitz, done such a great job, far surpassing the job of the former councilman in that ward. Ward 7, Bill Russo. I call Bill the rock of City Council. His steady leadership chairing two really critical committees, the Safety Committee and the Enterprise Zone Committee. Bill is at the forefront of all of our economic development, our business development. I want to thank Bill for his leadership. And then Nancy Meany, Ward 5 councilperson, vice mayor. I always say if you want someone to get the job done, you get a woman to get the job done, and that's what Nancy does. She does the most amazing job. She's got to deal with all these men on City Council, men like me. It's not so easy, but Nancy's the best friend, the best vice mayor that anyone can ever have. A lot of what we do happens because of Nancy. I want to thank her. I want to thank our Planning Commission. Great three citizen members of our commission, Greg Greenspan, Roger Newberry, and Bill Mazur. We lost a giant in our community this year, one of the toughest losses I think many of us have had in a long, long time. Joe Regano was superintendent for 33 years, was involved in our schools for 35 years, gave his life to our Solon schools. His character, his integrity, is compassion. I never knew anyone how they can calm a tough crowd through a discussion on school funding and all the various issues that went into some of the funding issues like Joe could do. I know Joe is smiling down on us for how Solon got through this together. In particular, Joe is smiling down on the Solon schools for the great job they did in keeping their students safe. And I want to thank the school board. What a great partner as far as Team Solon. Those are five of the smartest people that I ever met. My mentor, Mayor Kevin Patton, Leanne Jones, Julie Glavin, who's the chairperson, Marilyn Thomas, and John Heckman. Why do I say they're the smartest people in Solon? Because they had the goodwill and the understanding to select Fred Bolden as the superintendent. And that had a lot to do with how Joe mentored Fred as the future leader of the Solon schools. Fred learned from Joe. He exuded Joe's confidence. He exuded Joe's understanding of our schools and our school system, our kids. And most importantly, Fred's leadership with the school board through 2020, it got us safe. Through Fred and the school board, kept the safety of our students, the safety of our teachers, the safety of our administrators, the safety of our staff as the most important thing. And because of that, Fred and the school board kept the community safe. Another big part of our team, my team, is our directors. And you're never going to get a speech without some sort of football or sports reference, so here I go. Football season may have ended, but I still think a lot about the Buckeyes and the Comets and the Browns. So if I have to think about our team, I think about that we have three great receivers. One is Rich Parker. Yes, Rich, you're a wide receiver today. For the amazing job Rich did as our director of recreation, as you're probably aware, Don Holub retired last year, and Rich came in a very difficult time, keeping our parks and our recreation and everything that we hold near and dear safely, as Rich did last year. Another receiver, Tracy Sullivan, our director of Solon Center for the Arts, did such an amazing job with all her virtual programming, keeping the students safe, going back to camp this summer, having dance classes, theater. I just attended a recital, and Tracy's done such a great job as the director. Our rock star, Jill Frankel. What Jill has been able to do at our senior center, engaging our seniors, keeping our seniors safe, over 10,000 phone calls to our seniors. Every week there's a virtual program, there's an in-person program in the parking lot, whether it's the food pantry or all the various things. I attended last week a Mardi Gras celebration, a drive-through celebration, and I want to thank Jill for all of her work and her staff keeping everyone safe. We have two great running backs. Rob Franklin, our director of community development and planning, did such a great job through the pandemic. We even increased a lot of what we did through planning, through permitting, and through the permitting process and the planning process. And I want to thank Rob for his leadership. Angie Shaker, a true rock star. Angie, you did such a great job through this pandemic, and I will go through that. We're one of the few communities in Northeastern Ohio that actually added businesses through the pandemic, and we're going to talk a little bit about what the forecast is for 2021, and I want to thank Angie for all of her efforts in reaching out to all of our businesses. We got a great fullback in Chief Rick Tinelli. Rick's the lead blocker. He catches passes. He scores touchdowns. He's been just in over a year, but year and a half that Rick has been the police chief. He's done such an amazing job of our community police efforts. Rick has taken the lead in understanding de-escalation efforts and all the various things we're implementing in our police department. But Rick is truly the police chief of our community police department. Chief Mark Vetter. Mark is our medical technician. He's our medical director. He keeps us all safe. Mark and his team at the fire at Solon Fire Department made sure that they were fully equipped and made sure that they had all the PPE necessary to go into people's homes, and they went into homes where there was actually COVID there, but they made sure that they rescued them and kept everyone safe, and I want to thank Chief Vetter. My partner, Jim Gibbs, Mr. Technical Man, keeps everyone safe, and I call Jim Lights, Camera, Action. I'm here today because of Jim and his team, and they did such a great job even last year through the pandemic. We had the InterGov program. This year we're going to be introducing the ERP program, and just the updates here in our council chambers. Jim has done such a great job. I want to thank Nancy Stolarski. Nancy's our union rep. She keeps us all in line. She's been the director of HR for over 10 years, and I want to thank Nancy for the great job she did bringing Solon into the 21st century. And Nancy is retiring this week, and we're looking forward to Yolanda Guzman starting next week, but I want to thank Nancy for her great leadership and her great service. Now I want to go to our line, and the line is the heart and soul of the community. First on the line is Matt Rubino, our finance director. Matt and his team did such a great job in getting us through a very difficult financial picture. In March, we had projections anywhere from $38 to $39 million in revenue. Matt actually got us through the finish line at revenues of $42.3 million, much higher than we ever projected. And this year, we will anticipate revenues in excess of $43.1 million. John Bush, our right tackle. What a great city engineer John is. John has been with the city for a long time. He leads our engineering services. He plans all the construction projects. We had a busy construction season through all the work that John does. So I want to thank John for all of his services. Paul Solonix, our left guard. Paul heads up our water reclamation department, something that we all don't think about, but is one of the most important things in our community, making sure that we have clean water, good water, and everything is handled down at our water reclamation plant. Our right guard is Mark Hawley. Mark runs our service department, does such an amazing job, is relatively new on the position, and he heads up four different areas of our service, solid waste, streets, sewers, and fleet. We've even had some difficult snowstorms this year, and Mark and his team have done such a great job. The anchor of our line, he's the center of it all. He's the Public Works Commissioner Bill Dursick. Bill has been such a tireless advocate, and his efforts through the city, whether it's at Water Rec, whether it's the service department, engineering, Bill does it all. And I want to thank Bill for all of his service. I want to thank our two lawyers. I know the lawyers don't always get the great pub, but Lon Stolarski and Tom Lobe did such a great job of getting us through all the various legal issues. And yes, lastly, there's a quarterback, and it ain't me. I want to thank Maria Farley for being the quarterback, for getting all the team organized, for scoring all the touchdowns, for getting everything together, for leading the blockers, for the handoffs and everything Maria does just to keep me, because I'm not easy staying on task. So Maria does such a great job day in and out keeping me on task. Our Solon Chamber is such a great team player in everything we do. Tom, Kaylin, Michael, Mary Kay, look at all the, even during a pandemic, leave it to Solon. Through Tom's work and the chamber and Angie, we had such amazing ribbon coatings, even through 2020 with masks. Tom and your team had tremendous weekly programming for members to discuss the pandemic and its effect on all of its businesses. The regular Western Reserve Safety Council meetings kept everybody and everything safe throughout the community. I want to thank you for your partnership with Angie to make sure that all of the regular contact with our businesses, all 900 in the community. So I want to thank the Chamber. I want to thank the Rotary Club. We wouldn't be in Solon without the great Rotary Club and everything that the Rotary does. As you can see, some of the mobile food pantries that we have at Resurrection Church, the outreach calls that Rotary did for our senior community, the shopping and the grocery deliveries, and everything that that Rotary does for our community. I want to thank the community. When I say I've never spoken highly and more effective about Team Solon, I meant it this year. Look at everything that our community did. Every day, someone was dropping off food, was dropping off masks. As you can see, Bo Li and the Chinese group dropping off masks that he got from China, and he sent it to fire station number two. Nestle, what a great job. Every 2 weeks, Nestle would come with their frozen food. They'd come to the senior center and help our seniors pack the food up and deliver it. And every day, some community member would come drop off food at the fire station, at our senior center, make a delivery to our seniors, grocery shop, and getting pharmaceuticals for our seniors. And I've never been so proud of our community as we came together. And that's the real state of the city for the city of Solon, is everyone coming together, especially people in helping our most vulnerable citizens. One of my greatest nights was that beautiful night in June when we got together at our gazebo. And it wasn't, it was right after the brutal killing of Mr. Floyd in Minneapolis. And you know who organized that? It was the Chagrin Valley Islamic Center. And they brought all the religious leaders together on that beautiful evening. And there wasn't any protests. There was no breaking of windows. There was prayer. And there was discussion. People of all faith, all nationalities, all races coming together, and to make sure that we're addressing racism, but also honoring and highlighting everything that Solon does in terms of diversity, equity, inclusion. Last summer, when we got the award as the number one community in Northeastern Ohio, what did Cleveland Magazine say? It was our diversity. And so through that, from that beautiful evening in June, and then subsequently some marches that the students had, we convened a diversity, equity, and inclusion leadership course for the city. And I want to thank Councilman Bentley for spearheading the effort of an anti-racism resolution that was recently passed, but also highlighted so many of the things that we do in our community. So thank you. And there it is. Even through 2020, thanks to the work of the Chamber, through Angie, and everyone's efforts, we still added close to 20 businesses. Think about that, during a 100-year pandemic. And the city of Solon, through all of our efforts, added all of these great businesses to our community. So that gives me hope, it gives me optimism. When we work as a team, we're the best business community in Northeastern Ohio. And now it comes to 2021. What is 2021? Well, 2021 is going to be about Solon Connects. It's going to be about bikeable and walkable community. It's our partnership with the Cuyahoga County Planning Commission. We're going to enhance mobility. We're going to expand mobility. We're going to educate about mobility. And we're going to evaluate alternative mobility. We're going to fill gaps. We're going to improve safety. And that's what Solon Connects is for 2021. And here's a map of sort of, you know what? I have an idea. Better yet, show you all these boring maps that we do all the time. What I'm going to do, I'm going to have you join me on a little run. Even you, Shimmets, I think you can run around. So I think we're going to take a little run through Solon and show you a little bit about our new businesses, our upcoming businesses, and also how we're connecting.
All right, everybody. I know this is part of the state of the city, and usually, you know, we do all these projectors and PowerPoints, but I thought today is I really wanted to give you an idea of what Solon Connects is all about. So instead of just talking the talk, like most mayors and politicians do, I decided I'm just going to walk the walk, or for me, run the run. And so what I decided to do is we're going to take a little tour through the Central Retail District, really show you firsthand what I mean by Solon Connect, making a more walkable, bikeable, runnable community for all of us. So we're going to point out some of the few places that we're going to go through on our little tour of Solon Connects, and we're starting right here on the corner of Main and Main, Somme and Aurora, at one of my favorite spots, Imperial Walk. And so I want to give a shout out to Imperial Walk as our first stop. Come in, get some great sushi or whatever you want. And we're going to make our journey now westward down Aurora Road. While you're at it, everybody, as we're going down Aurora Road, going west, please stop at Jim's Open Kitchen. You've got to be the best breakfast in Solon. Please do it, and then you'll be able to get back on the trail. And by the way, across the street, if you don't know it's there, stop by my buddies at Simply Greek, the most awesome Greek food you're ever going to get as you walk and bike and meander down Aurora Road. So here we go, westward bound. All right, not tired yet, just going a little bit west. And I had to stop at Solon Square Shopping Plaza and our friends from Mid-America Management Company, really to spotlight some of the great places to catch a quick bite. First off, Izzy and Jay, our buddies at 56 Kitchen. That's gonna be a theme a little bit throughout this. Please stop by. You can go in and they have the best takeout that you'll ever want. You want the best bagel in Ohio, you go to DNR Bagels. I guarantee you, you will never find a better bagel. And I'm a connoisseur in bagels, I can tell you that. So please stop by. We have some other great spots. The new Sunny's location, the Indian food is right here. You've got so many great places, a new Dollar Tree in there. And for all of you millennials, yes, Chipotle is right there. So last summer, it's June. My son Jacob, it's his 18th birthday. So what do you do for someone who loves to bike on their 18th birthday? Well, you go to Solon Bike and you get your son and your daughter, your wife, anybody, a new beautiful bike. And that's what I did. I went to Solon Bike, I met with my buddy Dan Serkin, and I got my son a new bike. So I am so excited to be running here down Aurora Road into the new and improved Solon Bike Shop. Now Dan owns the building. He's putting in new bikes, so please, everybody, you need a bike, it's gonna be springtime in a couple weeks, go to Dan Serkin, Solon Bike Shop, right here on the corner of Aurora and Melbourne. As we continue down Aurora Road, big shout out for the new restaurant here, Vertigo, the former Mama Joe's place. Big shout out to Izzy Schachner, Michael Loya for partnering on this deal. And if you come here, I guarantee you, you can get some really great chicken and custard. I know, Mayor, you've been talking about this Liberty Ford site for a few years. I think the first state of the city, the second state of the city, the third state of the city. But yes, we are here on the Liberty Ford site, and we are going to have a new redevelopment on this site. And when I say redevelopment, I'm talking multifamily apartments, high-end apartments, hotel, and possibly some retail and some restaurants. So look at the site now. It's not the most beautiful site in the world, but one day, this ugly duckling will be transformed into a beautiful swan, and we're hoping for a beautiful new development on this Liberty Ford site as we continue to go westbound on Aurora Road. As we make our way from Aurora Road up Solon Road, you gotta stop at Alesha's. Whether you want some cavatelli, some pizza, the best wine you'll ever have, some gelato, make your way up to Alesha's as you're connecting on your bike, you're walking, you're running, whatever you may do, and get some good pasta. So as you make your way down Solon Road, we get to Station Street, and we start running and biking and walking down Station Street, and what do you need? You need some Java. You need some caffeine. We all need a little caffeine in the middle of the day, as probably many of you need it right now, listening to the mayor. So, greatest new hotspot in Solon, and I thank Thabar and his entire family for opening Heritage Coffee right here on Station Street. It's a cool, awesome place. Go inside, get some Java. They're actually gonna have some bike racks outside here so you can bike here. So please, please visit Thabar and get some great coffee or whatever you want, some pastries. And next to Thabar's is Taylor's place at the Butcher Pantry. Please stop in to Taylor's place. He's got some awesome meats, but the thing that I love the best at Taylor, he's got the most wicked beer that you will ever have in the world. Things that you'll never find at the shopping plazas. You like beer, good wine, go to Taylor at the Butcher Pantry. So right next to Mr. Chicken and Imperial Walk, hot off the press, New news. Breaking news. Yes, our city council just approved the new city barbecue that's going on the old Dino site. Big shout out to Steve Passoff, City Barbecue out of Dublin, Ohio, and their entire crew for making this site work, because now you can have access to City Barbecue right off either Aurora Road or Sun Center Road. We look forward to hanging out, having some barbecue right here on the beautiful new patio of City Barbecue. As we're biking and walking down Bainbridge Road, just by City Hall, you have, remember the old days of harvest, great food on the outdoor patio? Well, I can't give you a lot of details about this, but yes, a little bit of breaking news. We're gonna have a new and improved restaurant right here at the old Harvest Place. You'll be having a really cool patio. So stay tuned, you're gonna have more details. And right next to it, at the old Berkshire Hathaway building, there's gonna be a new fitness studio there. So yes, the new and improved Bainbridge Road is starting to take shape. And just another thing, right across the street, I wanna give a big shout out to Dr. Phil Bomley for his new doctor studio right across the street. So a new and improved place, and you can come and get your orthodontic work right across the street. So as you're going down Bainbridge Road, you come to one of my favorite spots. I know many of you have been to Italy. Italy's a great country, great wine. It's absolutely amazing, but I have a little secret for you. The wine in Solon is just as good, if not better, than in Italy. And the price is right. So when you're going down Bainbridge Road and you're biking here, stop at Swirl Wine Bar, visit my buddies here, the best wine you'll ever have. Here we are, down Bainbridge Road, and we get to Roll House. True story, everybody. Really a true story. Halfway through the pandemic, my kids are like, Dad, what's the one thing? Give me one thing more than anything else you miss during the pandemic. And there was only one thing that came into my mind, and it was like Christmas ale at Roll House with Glenn Gable and all my buddies. And that's the one thing I miss. That's the most biggest thing I miss about this pandemic. So if you're going down Bainbridge Road, stop and see Glenn and Sue here at Roll House, a total Solon institution. I remember back in the day dealing with Glenn's father and how we were able to help him expand this new and beautiful place here at Roll House. So stop by, bowl, have a Christmas ale, get some food, laser tag, and all the fun things that go on here. And if you're more inclined, go next door and visit the Escapeology right next door here and enjoy a fun night. As we're moving our way down Bainbridge Road West, big shout out to Pat Finley and his entire crew at Omni. What a beautiful new corporate headquarters that they built here. And right next to it, just to the west, is the beautiful new Vitalia Senior Living. People are moving into Vitalia. They're loving it. The hospitality, the care, the food, the service is first class. I welcome anyone that wants to take a look at Vitalia. They have independent living. They have memory care assisted living. Make sure you stop in and see the folks at Vitalia. Very excited to have the new drive-thru here at Panera Bread as we wind and bike and walk our way down Bainbridge Road and as we come up Cruzy Drive. Great addition. I had a couple people call me afterward and they're like, Mayor, I didn't know Solon approved drive-thru. And I said, hey, this is a new Solon, man. We say yes to business. We say yes to drive-thru. Can't wait to have the new drive-thru here at Panera. I want to thank Art Lawrence, Daryl Young for all of their work, the owners of this plaza, making it happen. Trip down Cruzy Drive and a trip through Solon Connects, whether you're walking, you're running, or biking, is not complete until you get to Mitchell's Ice Cream and have some double chocolate chunk or whatever is your favorite. They got the best milkshakes in the world. Stop at Mitchell's on your way when you're biking, and you will have no better ice cream in the world than Mitchell's Ice Cream. And if you're right next to Mitchell's, stop in at Burger Fresh, get a great burger, and right next door is Paint Nail, a great new business that just opened up in 2020. As you're going down Cruzy Drive, stop in at Uptown Solon, soon to be announced, a new ownership group here. You're going to have a new spot for the something in the Mustard Seed Plaza, but also all the great tenants here would love your business. You can stop in at the Rusty Bucket. You can go to Orange Theory. There's a new hibachi place. Go to First Watch. A lot of great places here. Stop in Uptown as you're biking and walking all through Seoul. As you're making your way down Cruzy Drive, one of the best new places to open up here in Solon. Yes, YT, yours truly. I think it saved a lot of people during that pandemic. Big shout out to the Shibley family, Jeff Davis, who owns the property right by Jeff's auto dealerships. I got a little secret to tell you. They have something here called Not-So Fries. If you've ever had it, don't worry, Rabbi, I get it without the bacon, but it's the most unbelievable thing that you ever have. So please, stop in. Yours truly, Not-So Fries. You won't go home hungry. If you're making your way down Cruzy, right at the corner of Solon, come to Burntwood Tavern. What a great place for food. Great happy hour here. You got a little outdoor plaza here for the nice weather. What a great spot right on the corner. So here we are, winding our way, almost finished down Cruzy Drive. When we get to Som Center Road, we get to, yes, I will say it, it's the hottest spot in Solon, Ohio. It's Chick-fil-A. What an amazing spot. Every kid in Solon High School, junior high school, this is their hangout. This is their go-to place. So proud of Chick-fil-A, what they've done for our community. What a great way to get through a pandemic is coming to Chick-fil-A and getting through the drive-thru. So happy that Chick-fil-A found their home here. It's the best Chick-fil-A in the United States of America, I guarantee you. Stop, get some chicken, get some brownies, best mac and cheese. Enjoy Chick-fil-A, Solon, Ohio.
Okay, thanks everybody for the journey. I hope you're sufficiently hungry. I'm a little thirsty, I'm a little tired from the run. So thanks for going on your journey as we connect the city of Solon through a bikeable, walkable community. Now I want to just show you how the connection is made from the west side, which is the central retail district, onto the east side of Solon. As you see in the middle there, that's the Norfolk Southern Bridge. One day that will go into the Norfolk Southern Trail that we're working on. And I want to give a big shout out. I know Tom's on there. Big shout out to my dear friend Dave Joyce. If it wasn't for David, Congressman David Joyce, we wouldn't even had a meeting with Norfolk Southern. So I want to really thank David, thank his team, thank Tom for getting us together with Norfolk Southern. Because as you can see, over that bridge is the Norfolk Southern Rails to Trails. And from that trail in Solon, Ohio, goes through Aurora, goes east to Youngstown, and all the way through the state of Pennsylvania. On the top of that, as you can see, is the Chagrin Falls Trail, which is a little bit smaller, but we own it, and that's a two-mile track that goes all the way down into the city of Chagrin Falls and right to the popcorn shop. Connecting those two trails is our connector that will connect the Solon to Chagrin Falls Trail to the Norfolk Southern Trail and run right through behind the Mark's parking lot, right through Bicentennial Park, which is across the street from the Solon Center for the Arts, and connect the two trails. So we will have a complete connection to all these different trails and access, whether you're walking, whether you're biking. And also, just a little bit south of there, you'll hit the Solon, the Market District Plaza, and make sure you go see George and get some good deli at Chicago Deli. So as you can see, you have to be able to connect the east with the west over Solon Bridge. Another thing we're very excited about in 2021 is our Solon Mobility Task Force. We are looking at and assessing public transit into Solon, exploring public-private microtransit solutions to making it easier for people to get here. It's one of the things that makes it difficult. If you live in Cleveland, if you live in different areas, it may be difficult for you to get to Solon. And we want to make it easier for people to come to work on time from work. We're collaborating with RTA to determine if bus service should be realigned or expanded to reduce that travel time. And we're going to overlay our data with the Solon Connects initiative to improve the safety and response and accessibility. And I want to thank Angie Shaker for really heading up our task force, John Bush for the city, our planning department, the Solon Chamber of Commerce that's involved, Tri-C. I want to thank the folks from Swagelok, from Nestle, Raptite, the Cleveland Clinic, for being such great partners. Magnet has been a very terrific partner through all this. The Cuyahoga County Planning Commission, Senator Matt Dolan, I want a big shout out to Matt for really spearheading this effort and bringing everyone together. And once and for all, we're going to be able to solve that first mile, last mile, so that when you get off a bus, you don't have to walk a mile to work, but there's a way for you to get to work. And we're going to solve it because we believe you have to have a public and a private partnership through this. We're still doing major infrastructure projects. I'm going to shout out with John again. We have about 25 different projects through Priority 1, Priority 2, and Priority 3, and we will be spending about $17.5 million on these infrastructure projects. Infrastructure every year is critical to make sure our city is running properly. Businesses and business development relies on infrastructure. And new residents rely on good infrastructure. And I want to say we have the best infrastructure in Northeastern Ohio because we don't pass the buck. We made sure we take care of our sewers and our streets every year so that we can keep growing and expanding as a community. And that's just some of the new businesses just in the first month in the city of Solon for 2021. And I want to give you a little preview of what's coming for some of our new businesses we're very, very excited about. The Scannell Properties, that's on Solon Road next to Sedlak's, will be a building that will house tenants. As you can see, the new beautiful building. What a great idea to rezone this as industrial, and we knew there'd be a great use here. About 294,000 square feet right by Errico Drive, where we welcome Scannell Properties for being such a great partner. We want to welcome Elite Dental. What a beautiful building this is shaping up right on Aurora Road, just east of the Market District Plaza, Phase 1, which is the current building, about 11,745 square feet. Phase 2, which is a future building, a little less than that, about 7,000 square feet. Welcome. I want to thank Gross Builders, Carrington Court, for building an additional apartment building that's going up right on Aurora Road. About 36 new tenants that will go in there. Great demand for this Carrington Court senior living just to the east of the Market District as you go down Aurora Road. And through great efforts and a lot of work and a lot of effort, we're finally going to have that connector road that connects Carrington Court through Clearwater Court all the way over to Ports Parkway, making it a lot easier and safer for our seniors that live in Carrington Court to get out onto Aurora Road. So now they're able to get out onto Ports Parkway. This is something that I think all of us, particularly my colleagues on City Council, have been looked forward to, and a great sense of pride in our community. Last spring, this property was rezoned to right by on Aurora Road, just to the east of Carrington Court, to multi-living with adults that live independently that have disabilities. One of the things we're most proud of here in Solon is that's one of the first of its kind zoning classifications in the entire United States of America. We have a lot of folks who have adults with disabilities and are worried about what's going to happen when they're not here and they're gone. And so very forward thinking, we made sure that there's going to be about seven multi-units there for adults with disabilities. And we're working on putting together all the construction details, some of the wetlands issues that will be happening. So. But it really, what it really says about Solon, it represents who we are as a community. It represents our values. And I'm so proud of the community for supporting this and voting to rezone the property. A beautiful new area in the southern end of town, which Mackie Bentley is very familiar with, it's the Blue Heron property. We've been meeting with the Ohio Department of Natural Resources, and we're coming close to forming a 120-acre state nature preserve. It will be the first state nature preserve in Cuyahoga County in northeastern Ohio. It's a beautiful piece of property, and one day we hope that people will be able to access it, see the beautiful Blue Heron property, the nature preserve, and be able to walk all through there. again, a testament to the great thoughts of the community of Solon, rezoning the Hawthorne Valley Country Club. To the right of it, you see it will be the new development. It's a 32-acre site. About 105 new homes with additional green space. And on the left of it is the full 150-acre, the former Hawthorne Valley Golf Course. And that, through a development agreement that we have the owners, that's going to be perpetual green space. What a great new concept. Not only are we going to have a new 50 and older community of empty nesters that we desperately need, but we're going to be able to take that 150 acres out of development and preserve it as beautiful green space in perpetuity. I want to welcome Digital Room, which is a new business coming to Solon. It's the largest upload web-to-print business in North America. It's going to be located at 30500 Bruce Industrial Parkway, 60 new jobs over the next 3 years. I also want to welcome IS Squared out of California, a fast-growing information technology company opening a data and cybersecurity center at 6045 Cochrane Road, 109 new jobs in 3 years. And I might add, when I talked to the owner of this company when he was in California and we had competition from other communities in the Midwest, he said to me, one of the most important things that we decided to relocate in Solon is your diversity. He's an Indian gentleman. He said, when my kids go to school, I want to make sure that there are other kids that look like them at your schools, and your schools were the best at diversity, equity, and inclusion. So I want to thank IS Squared for having the faith and coming to Solon and bringing the new and emerging cybersecurity technology to our community. Raptite, what a great company. Shout out to Suresh and Sunny at Raptite Packaging and Shipping Supplies. Their Raptite operations, even though they have them on Cochrane Road, two successful businesses, this business will expand at the 6250 Camp Industrial Road, which is the former Schwabel's building. They're going to be adding a sister company, which is Packaging Materials Direct. There'll be additional 51 jobs over 3 years. And I want to thank the entire Raptite team. I want to thank Angie, thank the Enterprise Zone Committee for putting this deal together. What a great use of the former Schwabel's building. Clean Express Auto right on Aurora Road just next to Burger King. That's going to be the new and improved Express Auto Wash. What a great concept. Pop Culture, which is a destination dessert shop. A big shout out to them. They're going to be on Solon Road just past Burntwood. So when they open up, please go over there. It's beautiful. What a great way to refit in the historic district with some great popsicles, some waffles, whatever floats your boat. But stop in at Pop Culture CLE. And of course, the piece de resistance for all of us, and this has been building, I think, for 3 years, since it's about 2018 when we first started talking to Swagelok, is the beautiful Swagelok Global Headquarters and Service Center that's really taking shape on the corner of Cochrane and Solon. This $40 million project is opening in May, and it's really going to highlight the growth in Solon's industry, technology, innovation, manufacturing sectors, not only Swagelok, but the possibility of bringing in other distributors and service centers that go along with Swagelok. And I just want to thank Swagelok for all of their efforts in keeping Solon as their home base. There's no place like home, as I always say, and they did such a beautiful job, and I can't wait to the grand opening very soon. And then lastly, as you can see, I think the sun is shining. The snow is going to melt a little bit. Spring and summer is upon us. We're probably still going to have to wear masks and social distance and making sure that we all get vaccinated. But as you can see, summer is upon us. And I know I, for one, can't wait till our summer season is here. Whether you go to Grantwood and play at our beautiful Grantwood Golf Course, play at our tennis courts, challenge me. Maybe Mackie still wants to challenge me at pickleball. Our two pools, recreation sports, well, our home days, all the various things, our pop-up in the park, our fall fest, our new farmers market that we're going to have, all of the various artists and the concerts that we're going to have in the park. Please join me for a great summer here in Solon. I think even Bernie Sanders is going to join us, as you can see him in the corner there on hole number two at Grantwood. So that's a little bit about our state of the city. I want to thank Team Solon. I want to thank all of you for your love, your support, in getting us through a very challenging and difficult year. Many of us knew people who were sick. Many of us lost friends and family who were sick. But we got through it together as Team Solon. And thank you to the Chamber. And lastly, I just want to thank Jim for all of your efforts. If it wasn't for you, I wouldn't be standing up here. Being able to do this virtually through the pandemic, and to Angie, to Maria, for all of their Rob and everybody that gave us information. So thank you so much, and God bless.